Elijah dipped in blood, and his name is called the Word of God. And the armies which were in heaven followed him upon white horses, clothed in fine linen, white and clean. And out of his mouth drove the sharp sword, that with it he should smite the nations, and he shall rule them with a rod of iron. And he turned up the winepress of the fierceness and wrath of Almighty God. And he hath on his vesture, and on his thigh, a name written, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Amen. Friends, this final generation that we're all living in now is going to be massively interrupted.
We help them, mate. We supply stuff for them.
So what about these people over here?
Well, if they come over and ask for help, we'll give them help.
Why should they
come over to ask for help when you know they need help?
Wait a minute, we have lots of people.
I'm the man who's walking through the centre now, who's bought into a tree.
We have lots of people. And then you don't know how many people we have. Come to us.
Listen, I've helped lots of people.
Well, we have lots of people.
Have you taken anybody in your house? Have you taken homeless people in your house? We have.
So what happens to them over there?
We'll help them. Don't worry, we'll help them.
I know, but so why are you taking people in then?
We'll help them.
We've got people.
We'll help them, yeah?
The climax of the ages. Time is running out. The days are evil, and the coming of the Lord is drawing nigh. And yet so many of us are wrapped up in the technology that this world has to offer. We've been consumed and taken over by the mass media propaganda machine. Life is very treacherous and perilous for many people. And yet the Holy Bible, in its ancient prophecies, describes the very day
Just go and do your own thing, mate. Yeah? Just go.